Here's what I want to bring to you on this day, is I'm bringing you not someone who is standard, but someone who stands out. And that's the question you all always have to ask yourself. With whatever they do, are they standard or do they stand out? This individual that I'm bringing to the microphone, his name is Ojinga Carr. And guess what he does? He helps business owners and entrepreneurs find clarity. And you know what? When you're clear, you can move with speed. When you're clear, you can move with purpose. When you're clear, you can move with passion. But the question is he a standard or is he a standout? I'm going to answer that question. He gives small business owners greater structure to help them, to help make them more successful. But when he does he do it as in a standard way or does he do it in a standout way? I'm going to answer that question in just a second. What does he do? Well, he's a consultant. He's a trainer. He's a master strategist. But the bottom line is, there's so many people who use these very same terms. And what happens is everybody becomes standard, but there's very few people who stand out. So the question is, I'm bringing to the phone, to this microphone, Ojinga Carr, and is he a standard or is he a standout? Well, you've heard of Fortune 500 companies. And if you had a Fortune 500 company, they take the top 500, and they're not the standard, they're the what? They're the standouts. Well, let me tell you about Ojinga Carr. Yes, he is a certified high-performance coach. Is he standard or is he a standout? I'm going to tell you. Only 400 people in the world have that designation. Wow. I told you about the Fortune 500 businesses. He is one of only 400 people in the world with the Certified High Performance Coach certification and designation. You answer the question for yourself. Is he a standard or is he a standout? You already know. He's a standout. Bringing to the microphone right now, Mr. Ojinga Carr. Ojinga, are you there?
I am here, Ruben. What's going on?
Hey, man, I'm hyped. I got my pen out, my paper out, and I'm ready to listen to you. Thank you for being on our show.
Man, you guys are on 10, and it's my job to get you to 20. That's it, because you guys are killing it this morning, already knocking it out, and I'm just so happy to be here on the show, to be home, as I like to call it, here with the Black CEO Morning Show, because I love getting the opportunity to be able to help our people and to be able to talk to our people. I spent a lot of time working in corporate America and working with a little bit of everybody, but I love the opportunity to be able to help us. And so I'm excited. I don't know if you can tell it. I'm excited to be on the line, and I really appreciate the opportunity, Ruben.
Oh, well, we're excited to have you, so thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I got to tell you, I want to talk to you about high performance. And so I want you guys out there, when you're listening, to hashtag that with the Black CEO Morning Show, high performance, because that's what we're talking about. When we're talking about high performance, you see, I'm an old athlete, and so we would get up for the game, and we'd be up for the game, and then the game would be over with, and then we'd go back down. And so it was kind of like a roller coaster up and down that we went through. But what high performance is about, it's about keeping that high level for a sustained level of time. So we're talking about sustaining ourselves for the level of time. So I'm going to talk to you today about high-performing teams, but I want to tell you a little bit about myself first. And I got a question for you, and it's a question that I ask my audiences all the time. And that question is, have you ever bargained with God? Have you ever bargained with God? You got to be in a bad place when you start bargaining with God. When you start saying, God, I'm gonna make it this way. If you get me out of this, I'm gonna be all right. I'm gonna do it the right way from this point on to be able to go forward and to be able to do it. You gotta be in a bad, bad spot. And I gotta tell you, I don't believe I'm the only one, but yeah, I bargained with God before. And so I was at a bad spot in my life. I was nearly 500 pounds. And so football hadn't worked out for me. I tore my knee up for the last time, and I decided to make food my best friend and also not get the things done I need to get done in my life and to be able to get those things knocked out. And so I found myself sitting, laying in a hospital bed and them telling me my sugar was 954. So if you know anything about diabetes, which I didn't even know I had at that time, if you know anything about that, your sugar's supposed to be around 90 or around 100 at the most. in that area. And so I was 10 times what I'm supposed to be. And so the doctor, they were whispering. And they were like, oh, well, I can't believe this, that he's still not in a coma or whatever. And so you hear all this scurrying around you, and this scurrying, and you find yourself just bargaining with God and saying, God, if you get me out of this place, if you get me out of this spot, that you can, that I'll do it, I'll make it. The problem with bargaining with God is that most of us bargain, and then we don't have a plan behind it. At that moment of desperation in your life, when you're desperate about your bills, you're desperate about your business, you're desperate about the things you need to get done, when you're at that moment of desperation in your life, you are willing to say and do anything at that point in time. But the problem is that next day, and that next moment, and that next hour, and next piece. So what I want to give you, I could give you a lot here, but what I want to give you here today is I want to talk about how it is that we put together high-performing teams. How do we perform better in our organizations, whether we are a solopreneur and we're working with other contractors, whether we have employees, whether we do it. And I got to tell you, it all starts with you. It all starts with you. That's the biggest thing, is we're going to figure out, how does this work for you? How do we get these things done for ourselves? And so I want you to tweet this out. I want you to send this out. Put it in the group. Be able to do it. What we've got to do every day, and what y'all are doing, I'm preaching to the choir here, because you're here on the Black CEO Morning Show. You're getting this great information. You're learning about the women's events. You're learning about how to be able to do your sales cycle and the sales cycle minute and everything like that. You're putting it into your business. What we got to do every day, and I want you to put this pulses out, is win the morning. We've got to win the morning every day. We've got to win the morning every day. If you can win the morning every day, then you're going to be able to make a change in your life. You're going to be able to help the people you need to be able to help. You're going to be able to put those things out. So we've got to win the morning. So write that down. Win the morning. So I'm going to give you a recipe to win the morning. Then we're going to talk about teams and how it is that we get our teams and how we get those things done. And so that recipe for winning the morning is 420s. Now, some of you may have been backsliding in your life or whatever as far as that. You might think a 420 day is something completely different. I'm not going to say what that is or anything along those lines. I'm in HR. That's the reason why I know what it is. It's not because I partook or anything along those lines. But it's about 420. 420s is what we're talking about. So 20 number one, when you get up in the morning, here's what I want you to do. I want you to get up an hour earlier, okay? And I want you to not touch your phone for an hour, because the phones are addictive. We get up, we get on the phone, we check and see what's going on in the Facebook News Network. We check and figure out what crazy thing our politicians have done overnight or whatever as far as that. We read about who all died, who all whatever, and your day gets consumed by that. So I want you to not touch your phone for an hour when you first get started with the day. And then I want you to do the first of these 420s. The first of those 420s is, drink 20 ounces of water. Drink 20. So when you get up in the morning, to get this day started right, when you get this day started right and get to rocking, it's 20 ounces of water. All right? So drink 20 ounces of water. And so that's going to get your fluids going. That's going to get you moving. That gets that sourness that's on your stomach when you wake up from all those different things. It's going to get you moving, get able to do it, because this is about taking care of with your health. And these are things that help me to be able to lose the weight, because I've lost over 160 pounds in my life. And also, they helped me to be able to take my business to another level as far as for high performance to be able to do it. So drink 20 ounces of water. That's the first of the 420. All right? The second 20 is that I want you to spend 20 minutes stretching, okay? So 20 minutes activating your body, whether that's stretching, whether that's meditation, whether that's yoga, whether that's Kajong, whatever those different things are that you're doing tomorrow, planking. I know we got the plank master here, different things along those lines. If whatever it is, 20 minutes immediately after you grab that water, you get out of bed, 20 minutes activating your body, all right? 20 minutes activating your body. And so I want you to activate your body, get your body ready. Get your body ready for the day. No, we're getting ourselves ready. We're rocking it out. We're making it happen. And so we're getting our body ready for the day and how we're doing it, okay? And then the third of those 20 is I want you to spend 20 minutes reading, all right? So I'm actually reading something out of a book. Now we're activating our minds, all right? So we're going to activate our minds and get ready. I'm on a challenge right now. I'm reading a book a week. For me, it's about How can I expand myself and expand my mindset and expand my business? And so the book I'm reading this week is Mindset by Carol Dweck. That's the book that I'm reading this week. But understand I'm reading a book a week, but we spent 20 minutes reading. So not on your iPad, not on your iPhone, not on your Android, any of those different things as far as that, like in a book, like that you get from a store. They still have those stores where they have those things in them that we call books. And so we are detaching ourselves, because if you get on your tablet, then what you're going to do is slide over to Facebook. What you're going to do is slide over into that email. And remember, your emails is just a place where it conveniently lines up everybody else's issues with you. That's what it is. It's a place, it's a holding place for you to be able to get these issues and to be able to do that and for to be able to put that together, okay? And so that's the third 20 minutes. Then your fourth of the 20, spend 20 minutes thinking about your day. All right. So I'm not talking about that you're just planning your day in the morning. Your day is already planned. All right. You got your day planned. You've got it figured out what it is you're going to do. We figured out what we're going to get done, everything as far as that. But 20 minutes actually thinking about it. So you got a meeting today. You got that closing meeting. How are you going to walk in that meeting? Are you going to have your headsets on and be hype as you come in? You going to have your music on and be ready? Are you going to be ready to go, ready to move through? With my team all the time, we have a little bit of fun. So we always talk about giving two claps on Ric Flair. So it's like, woo, like that, all right? So how is you going to roll into what is you doing? How are you going to knock things out, be able to get things knocked out, and be able to do so? So how are you going to handle that conversation you got to have with your spouse today? How are you going to handle that conversation with your kids? This time that you have that's planned for your kids, that you have planned in your schedule for 2 hours where you're going to actually focus on your kids and actually focus on them, how are you going to spend that? What are you going to do that's going to make that fun? Who is he going to surprise today? Who is he going to make happy today? I want you to think about it, because we used to think in football all the time that practice makes perfect. But actually, our coach would say, perfect practice makes perfect. So what you do is you sit and you think about what it is you're going to get done, what it is we're going to put together, what it is we're going to knock out, what it is we're going to put into our place and get done in our day. So you got to think about that. So you got 420. 420. 20 ounces of water. You're going to do 20 minutes of body activation, 20 minutes of activating your mind by reading, and 20 minutes of figuring out how you are going to win this freaking day. And when you do that, you're going to win the morning. So if you try that for 7 days, I promise you it will make a difference in your life. It will make a difference. It will make a change in your life, because now you are actually approaching the day with a plan and actually planning and being able to figure out how we get it done, how we knock it out, how we do that. So it's about you first, all right? It's about you first. That's the big thing. But then the next thing is, how is it that we work with our teams? So I'm going to share with you a football analogy, because I'm an old athlete, I'll tell you that. And so whether or not you know sports or not, I think this will serve you anyway. And so that's my purpose today, to be able to serve you and to be able to make sure that I have the right things for you and that you pull something out of today's call. You already said those 420s. I want to see you guys posting about that, posting about those 420s and what it is. But the next thing I want you to post about, as you're listening to this, posting in the forum, I'm going to come back and I'm going to check, and I'll talk to you guys in the forum and be able to do it, because this is some great stuff that I'm giving you here, all right? This is stuff that we charge our clients a lot of money in order to be able to learn. And so, but I want to be able to give and serve and be able to do it and give this information to you. So when we're working with our teams, the first step in your team is mutual purpose. Mutual purpose. Somebody posted out, mutual purpose, all right? So mutual purpose means that when you're working with your team, everybody has an idea of what it is that they are supposed to do. They have an idea of whatever it is they're supposed to get done, and we all are on the same page. So that means we had a team meeting this week. That means that we talked about it, whatever that is. So we're on a mutual purpose. So you think about this in football. I love football, and, you know, I got a two-year-old son. And so probably one of the bigger battles in my mind about that is whether or not I'm going to let him play football, because of all the things with CTE and different things like that. It's a difficult thing for me, because a lot of the reason why I'm successful as a man right now is because of football. Because football is one of the few places on earth where you have 11 people all facing the same direction and they are all have the same thing on their mind. So it doesn't matter about race. It doesn't matter about anything else. We're all wearing the same color, and we're moving forward with that color. And it's about advancing that color down the field and being able to do it. And so it's one of the few places on earth where you can do that, where you're not risking your life per se. But now feels that way sometimes. So we're in the huddle with a quarterback. A quarterback calls a play, and everybody knows what the play is. So do you have a mutual purpose with your team, with your contractor who you're working with? Do they know when it is you actually need to get this thing done? Have they talked to the other people? I was dealing with a situation where we had we're doing some work for someone, and so it was this big issue because the person kept not wanting what it was that was getting done because there wasn't a conversation, and we weren't all on a mutual purpose. If we're not on a mutual purpose, then you'll find yourself spinning your wheels, whether you're working in your brick-and-mortar business and you have your first employee or your employees with that, whether you are a solopreneur and you got contractors, you got deadlines and stuff. Everybody has to understand what the expectations are. So you need to know your expectations. That's huge. It's a huge thing. Write that down. Know your expectations. All right? So mutual purpose. I want to see you post it out. Mutual purpose. We have to have a mutual purpose. All right? So the second piece of it is empowered people. Empowered people. All right? So understand, in football, I got to trust that the guy to the left and the right of me know exactly what they're doing. I have to trust that the guy to the left and the right of me know exactly what they are doing, all right? That they know what it is that they're supposed to get done and that they know their responsibility. In your business, you got to trust people. Once you've given them something, you got to trust them. Because if you're going to micromanage everything it is that you have them do, then you're not going to get as far as you can get in your business. So I know that rock hit somebody as far as what it is with that, as far as micromanaging, because many of us find ourselves thinking that we're the only person that can do it the right way. And that's not true. That's not true in your relationships. That's not true in anything. The thing is that we have to be able to figure out, do we have empowered people? You have to give people opportunities in order for them to be able to move forward, in order for them to be able to get done the stuff they need to get done, and to be able to rock with it and roll with it. Okay? So that empowered people is so unbelievably important for you in your businesses, whether you are a solopreneur, whether you are a brick-and-mortar business, because we got to say, all right, cool, we gave this to the designer, and the designer has got that, and they're getting that done, okay? So empowered people, post that, write that down, because what I'm giving you here is you can look at any team, all right, whether we're talking about a sports team, we're talking about a business team. If a team is failing, they are failing in one of these four areas or one or more of these four areas. Okay? That's just what it is. Because we either don't have a mutual purpose, running around doing whatever it is we want to do, we don't know what it is, or we don't have empowered people, we're not allowing people to do, we're trying to do everybody else's job for them and be able to do it as well too, and we haven't empowered them to do it. And so now you've kind of taken their empowerment away, and so now they just do whatever it is you tell them to do. And so you got somebody here telling them, hey, you move this chair right here, and they move the chair, and they stare at you and look at you for what you're telling them to do next. That's going to drive both you and them crazy, okay? Because you're not doing another micromanaging another person, all right? We manage tasks. We manage money. We lead people. So if you're going to be a leader in your business, you're going to be a leader in your life, you're going to be a leader, you're a servant leader in your church, it's still the same thing. You got to empower the people around you to do it. Many of the people that's getting on your nerves, the people that's getting on your nerves and not being able to get stuff done, if you just gave them some more empowerment, if you just gave them something else to do, understand the fact that they might be able to handle those situations better for you. And now you're giving them some responsibility, and now you've given them that responsibility, and now we can rock and roll. We can move forward. We can move forward. We can make it happen. Because that's what we're looking to do. We've got to figure out, how do we make it happen? How do we do it? All right? That's unbelievably important. All right, the third one. The third piece right here for our high-performing teams. So the first one was mutual purpose. You should know that. The second one was empowered people. All right? So the third one, I want you to write it down. Post it out. Put it out here. This one I find to be the most important one of these four. This is a place where we see many people not be able to get this done, not be able to get this knocked out and be able to do so. And that is proper change communication. Proper change communication. So understand, we have to be able to show, we're talking about proper change communication, okay? So when we're talking about proper change communication and these different pieces with that, then you got to know that we're doing something different. I love it right here. I'm seeing on my phone all these tags coming in. You guys are listening. That's a beautiful thing. I appreciate that. I appreciate the fact that you're posting and doing it, because if you take this and use this, I'm telling you, this changed my life. Understanding this changed my life. And so I'm so happy about that. I see the post is popping in and popping in with that, with those posts. That's great. That's good. All right. So proper change communication. You got to communicate down with your team that something has changed in the way we're doing it. That something's changed in how we're doing it. That something's changed in what it is that we're getting done and what it is that we're approaching and what it is that we're getting knocked out. That we changed how we're doing. Otherwise, you're going to have people who are doing stuff the way they used to do it. And just because that's the way we always used to do it, and nobody communicated to them that it has to be different. You got to have proper change communication for yourself. Look, if you're going to step up and give them 420s in the morning, you better communicate that to yourself. You better write that down to yourself. You better let you, be able to understand and look and be able to say, this is the new me. It's October 20th. This is the only October 20th, 2017 we'll ever have. So guess what? Tomorrow is the only October 21st, 2017 we'll ever have. Tomorrow ain't promised to you. So if you're going to make that change, don't wait for a New Year's resolution. Don't wait for any of those different things with that. Make the change today. Be the change you want to see. See, we have all these cliches that we put on this stuff, right? We get all cliched up and everything about what it is we're going to do and, you know, rah, rah, rah. Understand, this year I made a promise to myself and to my people and to my tribe, and that was no fluff, just facts. Hashtag no fluff, just facts. It's too much fluff out here. It's too much fluff out here in the space of what we're doing. It's too many people telling you some fluffy stuff what I want to do is give you something that you can take and use today. Proper change communication is unbelievably important to me, because proper change communication cost me my football career. Understand, I was playing in a collegiate football game. I was playing left guard, and there was a left tackle that was right next to me. So he's right to my left. And when we had mutual purpose, we were in the huddle, and the quarterback called a play that was running away from us to the right. All right. So our blocking assignments, without getting too inside football here with you, our blocking assignments were that we were to block down. We had to block down. We had to take a step to the right and block down, okay? So I had empowered people around me. I trust my guy, my left tackle. I trust my center. I trust those people who are around me. I trust them, right? All right, but we're in a loud stadium. So the quarterback sees something different. He sees a weakness in the defense. That's that leadership, that you can make that change. And now we got to make that proper change communication. He sees a weakness in the defense. He sees that weakness is there. That weakness is there, what it is to be able to get done, right? He sees that weakness. And so he changes the play call, and they're going to run right behind us. So he makes this audible call, and we make a signal down the line, but the left tackle, he doesn't hear the signal because it was a loud stadium. There was too much going on. He was on Facebook. He wasn't paying attention to what was going on. That's in our life, right? We're distracted. We didn't win today. We didn't win the morning. So we're not ready. And so we don't understand that proper change communication, what it is, what it is to be able to get done and be able to knock it out and do it. We don't understand that. All right? So now I step forward to block the guy who's in front of me. Now I'm stepping to the left because I'm blocking the guy who's in front of me. And he dives down to block the guy who's in front of me, thinking we're still going to the right. I'm engaged with the guy who's in front of me. I'm blocking him. He dives into my knee, tears every ligament in my knee, ends my football career. Proper change communication is that important in your business and in your life. If you don't communicate with your spouse about that things are different and you have some different expectations and they're still doing it the way they used to do it, guess what? That's not going to work for one of y'all. One of y'all, that's not going to work out for one of y'all. All right, and probably you, because you're not communicating what those expectations are. If you don't communicate with your vendors what your new expectation is, that you need these things by this time, and you guys touch and agree on that, then that doesn't work. If you don't communicate to your employees about it, if you don't communicate to them about what it is that you need, guess what? That's your fault that it didn't happen. We didn't have proper change communication. We say, I got sucky employees. They don't understand. Are we communicating what's going on? Are we communicating the changes that are going on? It kills businesses left and right. I am a small business advocate. I want you to win. I want you to win in your life. I believe that you can win in your life. I believe that you can have the clarity and the content and the consistency to be able to move forward in your life. I'm loving it. I'm loving these. I'm loving these posts I'm seeing getting tagged across here. I'm loving that. All right. I'm gonna definitely get on after we're done. I'm gonna open it up for questions here when we get done here in just a moment anyway. And you can ask questions or whatever, but I'm definitely gonna get on. We're gonna continue the conversation because we need to make sure we are rocking out with high performing teams in our life to be able to do it. So keep posting, keep popping it. That's great. Okay, to be able to do it. So our four steps. First one was mutual purpose. The second one was empowered people. The third one was proper change communication. Finally, this is my favorite one, man. This is my favorite one right here. That is visionary leadership. Visionary leadership. So post it out. Post it out. Visionary leadership. Look, I know times are rough. I know times are hard. Before I became a certified high performance coach, I was a client. I went through a 12-week coaching process, changed my life. I couldn't see past today. So, man, I got this bill I got to pay today. I got this thing I got to work through today. Today. You got to be visionary. You got to see past today. You got to see a week from now. You can't be living. I know that we are in a society that says TGIF. Thank God it's Friday. Oh, it's hump day. I made it over the hump. I'm so happy I made it over the hump. Dude, we have to plan as if we're going to live forever. You live each day as if you're going to die today. You live it and live it out loud, live it full, live it in color, be able to do it. But you plan as if you're going to live forever. And so that means you got to be thinking about a month from now. You got to be thinking about 6 months from now. Because what happens if you're not thinking about a month from now comes up, you're still in the same spot. That's the way it works, okay? I mean, you either are moving forward or you're falling behind because the earth is constantly spinning. Okay? So it's constantly spinning. So if you're standing still and just sitting here in this space, then you're falling behind your competitors. You're falling behind in what it is to get done. You're falling behind in being able to get these things knocked out. And so understand the fact that we have to be able to show and look at the vision. That's biblical. Without vision, the people perish. So understand the fact that we have to have vision in our life. We have to have vision for what it is that we're going to do. We have to have vision for the things we're going to put together and have that visionary leadership. So then we have to have vision for our team. This is what team's going to look like a year from now. So let's work back from that. You work back from that piece. You say, okay, this is what's going to look like a year from now. So now let's work back from it. This is all common sense. But understand this, common sense is not always common practice. All right? Sometimes you need those common sense conversations. Sometimes you need those pieces for yourself to be able to understand it, to be able to do it, to be able to say, okay, this is how I do it. This is how I make it. This is how we're going to put it together for our business. Sometimes we need that in our life. We need that look to be able to say, all right, what are we doing 6 months from now? You know, people say all the time that be like a grocery store or like a department store. Department stores right now aren't working on their Christmas displays. The Christmas display is already done. Department stores right now are working on Easter. Department stores right now are thinking about what we're going to do for 4th of July. In your business, we have to be thinking that far ahead. It doesn't mean that we don't work for today. We have to make sure that we're working for today and being able to knock those things out and being able to do it, all right, and understand that. But you got to understand the fact that we have a vision for the future, a vision for the future of where it is we're going, and a vision for what it's going to get knocked out, all right? So you got to have that vision to be able to rock with it and be able to do it. And so that's where it is. That's what we're doing. And that's what we have to get knocked out. So to recap for you, if you came in late, write these down. Post these out. 420s for yourself. 420s for yourself. 20 ounces of water. 20 minutes of getting your body activated, body activation. Yoga, planks, kajong, stretching. Meditation, while you're doing it, okay? 20 minutes of reading out of an actual book, all right, about recent, and not necessarily, you know, a love novel. Read some stuff about your business. Read some stuff about the people who motivated, who did some stuff before you, who got those things done and knocked it out, all right? And then 20 minutes of how am I going to kill this day? And so we're going to win the morning. Hashtag win the morning. Win the morning. You win the morning, you win the day, all right? So you win the morning, you win the day. Then with your team, first of all, the first one, all right, is that we have to have mutual purpose. You got to have mutual purpose with your team. Know what you're doing. You got to then now have empowered people. Then the next piece after that is that then you have to have proper change communication. So unbelievably important. Cost my career. Cost my life. And then visionary leadership. In football, when you're talking about that visionary leadership and those pieces as far as that, understand that quarterback, when he sits back there in that pocket, he throws that touchdown pass. After the game, Tom Brady don't say it was me. Tom Brady says thank you to my offensive linemen. Thank you to the wide receivers. Thank you to everybody else because you have the leadership and the vision to see where those people need to be. You put them in the right places, but they did their job. Now we got our teams. We do our jobs. So I'm hyped this morning. We got to make this thing happen. And so I'm hyped. I'm so hyped I'm going to give away something to you for free. This is something that we charge $250 for, but I want to be able to give it to you right now for free. All right? I want to, if you want to hop on a call with me and see how you can gain clarity in your life, 1 hour with me, not somebody from my team, not some other person, with me, for 1 hour on the call, here's what I need you to do. I need you to text my name, Oginga. That's O-G-I-N-G-A. Somebody put this out into the post. O-G-I-N-G-A. Text Oginga to short code 31996. 31996. All right? You're going to text that to short code 31996. You're going to text my name, Oginga. You're going to fill out the little form that comes up with that as well, too. And we will get you in and get a chance to talk to you. I got an event coming up next week here in Memphis, Tennessee. It's going to be amazing. You can find out more about that as well, too. Hit me up. Friend me. You'll be friending me. You'll talk to me. And we're going to figure out how we're going to make this happen. We're going to figure out how we're going to knock these things out in your life. We're going to figure out how we're going to put these things together. Well, but let's open the lines up. We got questions or whatever as far as that. I'm hyped right now. It's whatever.